Hi, this is Representative Jeff Morris from the 40th District here on the House floor trying to share with you a technology minute or two. I'm going to talk a little bit about distributive energy resource planning, which is a complicated description to talk about where the electricity grid's going with your local utility. One of the things that we're seeing is that with every TV, dishwasher, refrigerator that we bought after the recession is it's using way less electricity than what we had before the recession. And what that's doing to the local utility is that they make money today by how much electricity they sell all of us. And if we're not buying as much, they're not in a sustainable business model to have a good, reliable flow of business to keep electricity on during storms and so on. What we're doing here is we're trying to figure out a new pathway forward for new business models. And it's an exciting time because new technology is allowing them to do that. As we buy electric vehicles or put solar photovoltaics on our roofs, it's great to have those at our house, but where we charge those and where we put those PV photovoltaic solar systems at is always not the most efficient place for the electric grid. So we're talking with the utilities about community solar, where you might have a solar system you buy into at a local school or a courthouse or another place in your neighborhood where you've got great sun. And also talking about where you may charge your car during the day where you drive to work as opposed to doing it at your home. If we all drove home every night with electric cars and plugged them in, that's literally 700 electric dryers because that's the voltage that they pull from the electric grid plugging in at the same time. What we're trying to do is find the places where the utilities can put community solar together with electric vehicles. That's what we call electricity as a service, and you might pay them $15 a month to charge your car all day while you're working. That's the low-cost solution that will keep electricity affordable here in the Northwest and keep us a world leader in keeping our carbon footprint low as well. Thanks for your time.